The Fire Book. In this, the Fire Book of the Nitto Ichi School of Strategy, I describe fighting as fire. In the first place, people think narrowly about the benefit of strategy. By using only their fingertips, they only know the benefit of 3 of the 5 inches of the wrist. They let a contest be decided, as with the folding fan, merely by the span of their forearms. They specialize in the small matter of dexterity, learning such trifles as hand and leg movements with the bamboo practice sword. In my strategy, the training for killing enemies is by way of many contests. Fighting for survival, discovering the meaning of life and death, learning the way of the sword, judging the strength of attacks, and understanding the way of the edge and ridge of the sword. You cannot profit from small techniques, particularly when full armor is worn. My way of strategy is the sure method to win when fighting for your life, 1 man against 5 or 10. There is nothing wrong with the principle, 1 man can beat 10, so 1,000 men can beat 10,000. You must research this. Of course, you cannot assemble 1,000 or 10,000 men for everyday training, but you can become a master of strategy by training alone with a sword, so that you can understand the enemy's stratagems, his strength and resources, and come to appreciate how to apply strategy to beat 10,000 enemies. Any man who wants to master the essence of my strategy must research diligently, training morning and evening. Thus can he polish his skill, become free from self, and realize extraordinary ability. He will come to possess miraculous power. This is the practical result of strategy. Depending on the place, examine your environment. Stand in the sun, that is, take up an attitude with the sun behind you. If the situation does not allow this, you must try to keep the sun on your right side. In buildings, you must stand with the entrance behind you or to your right. Make sure that your rear is unobstructed and that there is free space on your left, your right side being occupied with your sword attitude. At night, if the enemy can be seen, keep the fire behind you and the entrance to your right, and otherwise take up your attitude as above. You must look down on the enemy and take up your attitude on slightly higher places. For example, the kamiza, or spiritual center in a house, is thought of as a high place. When the fight comes, always endeavor to chase the enemy around to your left side. Chase him toward awkward places and try to keep him with his back to awkward places. When the enemy gets into an inconvenient position, do not let him look around, but conscientiously chase him around and pin him down. In houses, chase the enemy into the thresholds, lintels, doors, verandas, pillars, and so on, again not letting him see his situation. Always chase the enemy into bad footholds, obstacles at the side, and so on, using the virtues of the place to establish predominant positions from which to fight. You must research and train diligently in this. The 3 methods to forestall the enemy. A great swordsman, or any other artist, will have mastered the ability to forestall the enemy. The great swordsman is always before his environment. This does not mean speed. You cannot beat a good swordsman because he subconsciously sees the origin of every real action. It is the practiced ability to sum up a changing situation instantly. The first is to forestall him by attacking. This is called ken no sen, to set him up. Another method is to forestall him as he attacks. This is called tai no sen, to wait for the initiative. The other method is when you and the enemy attack together. This is called tai tai no sen, to accompany him and forestall him. There are no methods of taking the lead other than these 3. Because you can win quickly by taking the lead, it is one of the most important things in strategy. There are several things involved in taking the lead. You must make the best of the situation, see through the enemy's spirit so that you grasp his strategy and defeat him. It is impossible to write about this in detail. The first, ken no sen. When you decide to attack, keep calm and dash in quickly, forestalling the enemy. Or you can advance seemingly strongly, but with a reserved spirit, forestalling him with the reserve. Alternatively, advance with as strong a spirit as possible. And when you reach the enemy, move with your feet a little quicker than normal, unsettling him and overwhelming him sharply. Or with your spirit calm, attack with a feeling of constantly crushing the enemy from first to last. The spirit is to win in the depths of the enemy. These are all Ken no Sen. The second, Tai no Sen. When the enemy attacks, remain undisturbed, but feign weakness. As the enemy reaches you, suddenly move away, indicating that you intend to jump aside. Then dash in, attacking strongly as soon as you see the enemy relax. This is one way. Or as the enemy attacks, attack still more strongly, taking advantage of the resulting disorder in his timing to win. This is the Tai no Sen principle. The third, Tai Tai no Sen. When the enemy makes a quick attack, you must attack strongly and calmly. Aim for his weak point as he draws near and strongly defeat him. Or, if the enemy attacks calmly, you must observe his movement and, with your body rather floating, join in with his movement as he draws near. Move quickly and cut him strongly. This is Tai Tai no Sen. These things cannot be clearly explained in words. You must research what is written here. In these three ways of forestalling, you must judge the situation. This does not mean that you always attack first. But if the enemy attacks first, you can lead him around. In strategy, you have effectively won when you forestall the enemy, so you must train well to attain this.